There we go. Let me just turn off this, because I don't need gameplay music blasting while I do this. No, I do not. And, alright. So, this is Haeravon of Gamer Guides, and, yeah, Claire's little venture into The Witcher 3 made me go, you know what? Maybe I should do a little bit of streaming on their channel. Not to, snipe the thing Claire's working on, but, well, I have this whole little island here that I need to cut media for. Well, actually, record media for. So let me start up my Elgato real quick so I can record while I play. We'll try to get some video footage, which is where I'll pull my media while I stream. And hopefully my laptop and internet connection do not implode under the duress of trying to do too many things. And I'll send a little Facebook message to try and get more people in here. And then we will get on with it. So I hope some people stuck around from before. If so, thank you. Awesome. Excellent. And I know that Jared had better be here. You still here, Jared? I'm looking at you. All right. Let's get on with this, then. Hopefully the... I turned the game volume down to essentially 10%. Because I hate when people just have the game volume blasting as they are playing. Woman, get out of the way. Holy crap. I'm her. Okay, thank you for sticking around, Jeebus. This is my character. I'm a little further along. I originally wrote the Gamer Guides guy. Actually, it's on GameFAQs too, but that version does not appear to be getting an update. So, you can find the updated version on Gamer Guides. And I pretty much played this for like 5 weeks straight when it came out to get a guide serviceable in time. I have no idea, man. It should... I'm streaming it off my PlayStation 4, just like Claire was, so there shouldn't really be anything fishy going on that ways, but I just gotta play a little quick game of Gwent here. Everyone loves some Gwent. But yeah, I played the game 5 weeks straight, and then I could not stand to play it another second, and it was pretty much a year before I got back to it, so... Oh, they're just giving me all my spies. And you passed already. You are a boner. I'm going to take this round, and it would be very nice if you would give me some cards that were not just a bunch of boosting cards. I could actually use some unit cards. Maybe Thaler will help me out there. And once I'm done with this, I will get to questing and doing all kinds of witchery stuff around Faroe. And I won't necessarily be playing through this in the same order in which it will appear in the guide. It's not really super necessary at this point in time. So, yeah. This guy, he has a really, really crappy monster deck. But even if he had a good one, I have Villain Trenton Murth down there, my good old dragon, so he doesn't really have a chance. I'm just going to stomp him into the ground. Oh, wow. Could you take any longer to play your cards? There we go. And I should... By the time I'm done with Faroe, I should have all the Gwent cards in the main game. That'll be the second time I've done that. It's not too hard if you just follow the guide. Non-partners. See, I don't know anything about this Twitch business. I just stream here occasionally. So would it be me or them affecting the ability to change the quality? Because I think Gamer Guides is a... I think Seb went and paid for a Not a partner. No, he didn't. He bought the Gamer Guy or Twitch Turbo or whatever the hell it was. Whatever. I know he spent some money on this. And yes, I'm playing Gwent. Jared. It's only the best minigame since Blitzball. Thank you very much. Okay, enough of that. Now there's a quest I can start right here. And like the title says, I'm playing it in Death March difficulty, and I don't consider myself to be a great gamer, but I would suggest most everybody play the game in Death March difficulty, because honestly, I find it more fun. And maybe you will too. Except for when enemies just randomly start dealing like twice or three times the damage they would normally do. I still haven't figured out why that happens. I was fighting some white wolves earlier, and normally they do pretty negligible damage to me, even on Death March mode. But these ones were killing me in 3-4 hits and just ripping through my Quen shield and everything. I'm like, what the hell? But it's a trend I've noticed that sometimes, I had it happen earlier with Echidna. Yeah, yeah. What's the point of talking to people, getting them to tell you their quest details, and they're going, nah, screw you, buddy, I ain't doing it. I mean, I guess it's nice to be able to decline at the time, but oh well. Screw it. Let's get to exploring. There's lots of stuff hidden away on this island, including some Witcher sets. We're going to start out by going east first, because that's where this dude's quest takes me. And if you go a little bit east, I think I need to go west to find a road wrapping around to the east, actually, based on how things are set up. But you'll get an excuse to go back west if you go east first. And no, there's another. Okay, right, it's by the shore. Dirt. I like to try and kill as many birds as possible with as few stones as possible when playing games and writing guides, so I hate backtracking. In this game, though, it's kind of a necessary evil, because they just randomly intersperse high-level creatures and events throughout, so oh, well, what can you do? So, I want to climb this mountain up here, because there is a quest you can get that isn't readily available, or, well, readily apparent, I should say. And, yeah. Want to go up here. But like I was saying earlier, I was, I did my first playthrough of this game. What's everyone screaming about? I used the, cat set. Guys, you're watching an arena battle, so why are you screaming like you didn't expect someone to get stabbed? I've not seen you here before. What do they call you? Geralt of Rivia. I'm Yuta Undimon. Is she the only person in the history of this world who doesn't know who Geralt of Rivia is? Yeah, of course. Geralt's always ready to fight random people. See? Fair enough. How has she not heard of Geralt? He's a legendary swordsman. I mean, half of Skellige's heard of him. I'll fight you if you defeat Gundar. Couldn't best me, but he's a brave man and a worthy opponent. Good. I'll give it a shot. See you soon. Oh, she just randomly gives you a objective, doesn't she? Huh. I do know what you mean. One of the few random romances, and if you want to call it a romance, one of the few random sexual encounters in The Witcher 3. They kind of toned it back after the first game. In the first game, you could go around and collect sex cards everywhere. Okay, so is there a safe way down here, or should I stop being a wuss and just... Yeah, I can probably slide down here well enough. There we go. So, pick up that quest and then go explore this cave up here, as there's good stuff inside. I can't avoid picking up mushrooms. Oh, there it is. There's the iconic wolf symbol telling you that sweet ass gear lies around the corner. And oh, come on, you can loot it. Oh, I better loot it quickly. All right. Oh, you can't break those stalactites, stalagmites. Look at them chest. Okay, we will try to get it from here then. There, that works. Ard was the one I needed. Oh, there's two doors. Okay. Now this is a monster den location, but I don't see any monsters, so. Jared, you heard me whining about this a little bit earlier. Oh, that's some nice loot there. I'll take the silver ore. And let me. There should be a chest in here with a Witcher diagram. Okay, wonderful. So let me go find a good location from which I can get a screenshot of it. No. Let's light these up. Better lighting conditions for when I pull this screen. All right. And it's not in that one. It's in the dumpy looking one. Yeah, I guess it is. Ah, that one's harder to get in. Nah, that'll work. All right. Screenshot gathered. Hooray. Mastercrafted feline silver sword. And considering all the work I had to do to get that, it really kind of seems a bit underwhelming for a master level diagram, doesn't it? Oh well. So, that lady warrior on top of the hill, she can give you one of two quests. Apparently she gave me a different one this time. One is to defeat some guy in town called Gunder. Let me track that quest. Gunder. I wonder if you have to beat him in a normal fight or a fist fight. Oh well, we'll find out shortly, won't we? Now, where are you, Gunder? Get out of the way, animals! Or I'll let Claire in my game and she'll murder you all. Well, looks like it's gonna be a fist fight. Hey there, Gunder, buddy. What a pervert. Presented her an altogether different sort of challenge. It seemed a little unapproachable to me. She awaits a man she can't defeat. In fact, she's declared that only a man who beats her can hope to woo her. Interesting way to look for a husband. I'm not sure it's marriage she's after. A lass like that's 1 in 10,000. Well, they're just kind of laying it all on the line there, aren't they? Asking out of curiosity, given you're a foreigner. All right. You'd have said she'd fight me. All right, talk to you later. Thanks for stopping by. Means that if I win, she'll give me another chance. Well, come on. Now they're fighting for a little bit more than just prestige, huh? Fist fight. No, this is not a fist fight. Oh, crap. Oops. Let me equip this weapon, right? There we go. Oh, I have to fight them all fair-like. Oh, wow, he's got a lot of hit points. Am I using the right sword on him, or is he that strong? He's gonna kick my ass. I'm shit at sword fighting without my signs. There we go. No, that was the right sword. He's just got a crap ton of hit points. Alright, I'll heal. No shame in healing. There we go. If I can heal, I wonder if I can put oil on my blade. I could probably use the damage boost against this guy, considering how much health he seems to have. Where are you at, Hangman's Venom? There we go. There we go. And I can only hit him if I happen to parry him. That doesn't seem fair. There we go. I'm getting the hang of this, I think. Cutting it a little close with your health there, buddy. Dude. Oop. Ah, did I step out of the ring? Lame. Alright, I'm gonna have to try that again. Blah, blah, blah. Let's go try that again. But with less failure and a little more success this time. Wow, I have to hit him like 20 times and he only gets, or has to hit me 3 or 4. Cheap! It's like I'm playing it in the hard difficulty or something. Try to use oils from the very beginning and let that damage over time do some more of the work. Maybe drink a swallow potion instead of relying on white. Well, swallow potion doesn't have a super large duration either. Alright, I'm going to try and finish this one up and then I'll go to the alternate place this quest can take you just for the hell of it. That was the last checkpoint save. Game, you're an asshole. Let me apply that oil. Preemptively. There we go. And back down the side of the mountain. Yeah, he'll probably slide down that, won't you? No, I don't trust him. If only there was a more direct path up there, that would be nice. Lazy skeletons not crafting your island correctly. And let's make sure this is tracked in. No, this one. The Price of Honor? What the hell quest is that? I should probably check into that sometime. That should be crossed off my quest list. I don't remember it, so it shouldn't be there, damn it. Alright, let's make sure that I have a save somewhere else. A matter of life and death. Nah, that's not one I need to save. Alright, you and me again, Gundar. Yeah. Need to mine the edge of the ring this time. Come on, poison. There you go. Excellent. I didn't actually think I parried him that time. God, he gets his guard up almost instantaneously, doesn't he? Cheat! Ah, I keep thinking I didn't get the parry when I did. There we go. Got out of that time. Shouldn't be too many more hits for you now. Let's end this. And I'm gonna let the poison hopefully do you in. Are you fighting till you're dead? There we go. Woo!
All right. Enough. You fight well. Not well enough. Good luck with Yuta.
Yeah, apparently I'm going to need it if she fights like that. Crap. All right, let's go find that other thing Yuta can occasionally send you after. Let's go put a map marker to where the area is now. Yeah, just at the end of this road. Anytime in a RPG when there's a road that seems to go nowhere, just explore it, just in case it actually has something at the end of it. And, yeah, I have Quenra. Oh, it gave me my health back. Well, that is unusually generous for this game. Usually they don't give you your health back. And for the sake of posterity, Jared, you notice how I'm not killing all the poor little wildlife? Right? Unlike some people who can't help their murderous instincts. Slaughtering geese in the middle of the village. I tell you, Claire's a menace sometimes. And everyone's favorite obnoxious frickin' foe. Sirens. And apparently I don't have their attention yet. I'm sure they'll come after me when I'm not ready to fight them. There's one, at least. And the alternate form of Quen with its ability to explode. Very good at leaving foes vulnerable to attack. Level 19 Echidna, huh? I ain't afraid of you. I could put hybrid oil on my blade to make this go faster, but these things really aren't a threat. Come on. If at first you don't succeed... Oops, did I knock you out of the sky? Okay, there's four of them dead. These ones probably won't be nice enough to leave me alone, but I think I can deal with them underwater if they pester me. Right, now if Yuta doesn't send you to go fight Gundar, you instead will have to come over to this shipwreck and claim Horned Hjaskald's sword for her. That's the other thing she can send you to do. So, just in case, covering all my bases here. Yeah, I hear you things screeching. Let's get out of the water here. All right, come on. That's enough out of you. Yeah, echidna are really nice. If you can get them on land, try to kill them there. Because they very frequently will drop seashells. Ah, seashells. And while they aren't very useful on their own, you can dismantle them into black pearls. Yeah, every seashell on echidna drops will give you a black pearl, which sells for quite a bit of money. It's one of the few ways I know off the top of my head to accumulate crowns in large quantities. Well, I guess I'm like Claire after all. Eh, if I didn't blast them with Igni, these damn goats would just get in the way. So, Igni it is. Alright, let's go talk to Juta. And no, you perverts, I don't think I'm going to complete that quest on this stream. I think Gamer Guides is a mature rated channel, but yeah, you can go YouTube the ending of that quest on your own if you want. And right. No. I was right the first time. I want to go all the way to the docks. All the way to the docks, and then follow this road up the side of the mountain. And it'll lead me to Juta. Damn Nordic names. And why not try to take a shortcut? Because you don't know where you're going, and you'll probably screw it up. No, I got there. Wonderful. Okay. And yeah, Yuta's probably going to kick my ass if she fights like Gundar. But I can cheat a little bit. It does seem kind of dishonorable to put poison on your sword, right? Are they supposed to be holding something, or... Because it looks like they're supposed to be holding something, but they're not. Oh, well. Let me put on this oil, because I'm a freaking cheater. Okay, Juta. Oh. Well, you can give her the sword even if she doesn't specifically ask for it. Whatever, that's not what I did. I beat Gundar, so... I'm gonna get my ass kicked. Yeah. Frey ain't gonna choose nothing. Nope. Oh, nice poison. Ah! Do I actually get her hit her twice per parry? Yes, I do. Juta, you might be easier to beat than Gundar. Yep. Apparently she doesn't get her guard up as quickly. At Kaer Morhen. From Vesemir. There we go, at Kaer Morhen.
At Kaer Morhen.
Kaer Morhen? That's terribly far. But you learned a great deal on the road as well, surely. Would you tell me about it?
It'd make for a long story.
All right. We need a quiet spot, some good mead, and... What do you say?
It's not going to take me right there, is it? Okay, good.
Too rowdy. Come to my home in Harbigan. I'll be waiting after dusk.
See you later, then.
And I will let you all peruse the results of that interaction somewhere else. Me, I've got stuff to do. Important stuff. Monsters to fight and whatnot. Did it heal me after that one, too? I'm going to be surprised again, but only so much if the game healed me after that. And I've got to go back to this monster den, unfortunately. Because the last checkpoint wasn't terribly good. Same garbage here, too, huh? Alright, remember that there was a bunch of good treasure through here. Oh, quit whining, Geralt. Yeah, that's what I'm after. Why am I doing this? I already got a screen cap worthy image. Okay. Yeah, now that's supposed to be like a level 34 quest to get some of that gear, so a lot of the gear that you can get, they hide it behind high-level sounding quests, but then when you actually go after it, it's pretty much unguarded. There'll be like one of the pieces of gear that has a tough monster next to it. Oh, you're hunting things? Okay. Enemies with weapons shooting things, they get me a little wary, so now, I thought there was another. Right, there is. Let me go tag this quest. Because there's another piece of it somewhere down here, and it's not very hard to get either. Yeah, okay. So I'll go after you. And ignore that little skull. It's not going to be difficult. We're not going to have to fight a single thing to get this. And then I can move on towards the slavers. Oh, yeah, it did fully heal me. These are the wolves that killed me earlier. So I should probably save. And I hate wolves in this game. They just sit there and will attack you ceaselessly, like. Okay, and see, they're doing almost no damage. They killed me in 4 hits earlier. Oh, Geralt. Why do you swing at air? Now, one stupid thing about damage over time effects like fire is that, actually, I think it might only be fire that works this way, but if you hit an enemy that's suffering from a damage over time, they'll stop suffering from it. Like, if I were to hit those wolves while they were burning, they would lose the burning debuff, which is, I don't know. That's kind of dumb. Yeah, not so tough now, are you? So, I thought this thing was down by the shore, but I suppose I should follow the map marker to find where it is. Alrighty. Yeah, it was down by the shore. I should have just followed the coast. Oh well, this'll work. Let's see if I can ignore these sirens. Just get to the treasure. And it's pretty much a general rule. Most Witcher set items have to be in ruins or caves. Don't ask who made up the rule, but there it is. Alright, so the trick behind this one is there are some doors that need to be opened. Stupid lazy doors not opening. But if you did the first cat school quest, you should be familiar with these whole little statues and flipping levers and all that fun stuff. Now, there's a secret to tell which one of these. It's not really a secret, but there's a way, I should say, to tell when the statues are in place and when they're not. When they are not in place, they will be glowing red. When they are in place, they will be glowing yellow in your Witcher senses. Also, they'll have some white particle effects floating in front of them. That tells you they're in the right place. So you are in the wrong place. So let us fix that. Really? You're still not in the right place. All right, they have to face each other. Come on. You can do it, Geralt. It's a lever. It's not that difficult. There you go. Now you're in the right place. And I hear the sound of something, like, crawling around in this cave, but whatever it is, it doesn't want to fight, so I'm going to let it be. And there we go. Open doors, no fuss, no muss. And they still have the nerve to force you to Ardawall down. Hooray! And of course, behind the wall, you'll find sweet, sweet treasure. Although, unfortunately, or rather fortunately, if you don't want to deal with the puzzles, all the good treasure is not behind those doors. And there is a good bit of sweet-ass loot right outside here. Just hiding behind these well, I guess it's a column if they're touching, aren't they? And that happens to contain all the mastercrafted armor for the feline set. Yay! Alright. And I'm not doing the next part because I think that's the only part of this scavenger hunt that actually forces you to fight a strong enemy. Why bother, right? And let me just check to see if there's anything else here. Nope, you're on Ard Skellig. Wolf gear. You are on Ardsk, right? You're part of that Witcher contract. Alright. I didn't do that yet. I thought I already did that one. Let's scroll a little bit faster. Oh no, I guess I didn't go up there yet. Right, you follow that road by Blandair to get up there. Griffin school gear. Where is the last bit of you? Are you anywhere on that? Nope, you are all the way back up here. Okay. So, just got to deal with a little bit of slavers on this island, including their boss, who Lambert wants killed, because, well, Lambert is Lambert, I guess. No, go away, sirens. I don't want to fight you. You're a pain in the ass. Go away! Oh, they're harpies. Well, even more annoying. Leave me alone. Act like it's my job to kill monsters or something. And let's not run off any cliff faces. That would be dumb. That wouldn't look too smart on the stream, right? I should be able to just follow this road into the town. There they are. Now what the hell is a dagger? I should probably look that up. Jared, you're the person who looks stuff up for me when I don't know what it means. What's a dogger? It's like Norse for guard or pirate or...
What do you want?
business. Keep prayers at the chapel on the hill this time of day. If it's slaves you're looking to buy, you'll have to wait till they're done. I'll be back. Drink last night too?
Yeah, what's a dogger?
I'm looking for...
Oh, you can only do this conversation, huh? I think this gives away the game. I hate archers. Okay, archer. Oh, wow, there's a lot of archers. I'll just go somewhere where they can't shoot me and kill their friends, and then I'll get back to them. I always like a messy coup de grace. Ooh, I chopped a dude in half. Gross. I love it. Are you sitting up on that hill shooting at me? You are so murdered. See, I wouldn't have been abused this Quen sign so much, but you really only get one hit out of them if you parry them anyway, so why not just do something that doesn't require any timing and heals you at the same time? Boop! There goes your head. No, 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 not Draugr, Dogger. D-A-G-R. It can't possibly be the same thing. So I'm wondering if you can even do that quest if you've already started the other one. I see that archer back there too, little chump that he is. Damn you, Axie! You're supposed to give me an auto kill. Okay, well, apparently he doesn't want to anymore, so... Let me apply some hangman's venom. Oh. Okay. Yeah, how do you like that? Shoot at me some more, why don't you? Bastards. That's a weird name for them, huh? Alright. If you're just gonna sit there and not do anything, I'll come back to you later. No, I see you. Weird that I didn't do a coup de grace there, but he's dead, so I'll take it. Ah, oh, you're such a jerk. He still had his bow in his hands. He shouldn't be allowed to parry. Cheating game. Alright, let's go up. Okay, seriously, Geralt. If you won't go around, you won't go over. And this guy's kind of just stuck in his own little corner here, so... Yeah, have fun with that. I'm just going to hit you with Igni and shoot you. And my stamina's regening, like, instantly, so I guess it doesn't even view me as in combat with him? Whatever. You're lost, I guess. Sucks to be you, buddy. I'm a little bit curious if you have to skip doing this part now to do another quest later. Orders for Hammond. Because it didn't trigger for me, and they didn't give me the same dialogue options I'm used to getting. So that's weird. I'll have to investigate that a little bit more. This quest with Hammond might be conflicting with things. Alright, speaking of Hammond, let's go find him. He is at a shrine up over here. So it looks like I just gotta follow the road. Damn Skellige, it's always raining. Stupid rabbit. It's weird though, you can't loot those rabbits like you can loot the normal ones in the continent. I'm not sure why their snow rabbits don't like to be looted. Price of honor. Where did I start that at? Oh, okay, that's that quest from in town. Alright, well, I'm here, so I might as well do this as soon as I can find a way down that won't murder me. So I'm looking for this dude's brother, his shipwreck. Well, not his brother, his friends, I think. Oh, sirens, that's not a good sign. Well,
blue and bloated. Didn't seem to bother the sirens, though. Must have nabbed her body soon after she drowned. Kira's lamp ought to prove really handy here.
Oh, wow. We're going back to this lamp. How long has it been since I've used this thing, game? No, no. Let's switch to the right thing. Dude in town ain't gonna be happy about that, huh?
Only blood can. Let's do it as it must be done. There, beneath the tree. You pray, and then end it.
Aye, you're right. Be better that way.
Ah, Skellige.
Prince, wonder where they lead.
You and your sense of honor. Okay. Da 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 da, Inspector Geralt. Da 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 da. Da. Alrighty. Don't tell me you sissies hanged yourselves. No, maybe they fought each other in ritual combat. I'll be disappointed if they hung themselves or something. Two families, blah blah blah. Go, go, Geralt Arn. Yeah, there you go. Well, be a shame if that dowry went to waste. I mean, right? Investigate the crime scene. This isn't really a crime scene, is it?
Chose to die instead of living with the knowledge they'd let down their brother.
Yeah, I'll do that in a little bit, but first, I have another quest calling to me. And I can't just, you know, leave it alone. I'm all the way over here. I might as well, right? So there's that shrine. That's a profoundly ugly dude.
What? No.
Heard you were in Carradine's band.
Fucking say what you want. Come on, spit it out, you arse-licking bastard.
I love that tact. You arse-licking bastard.
Friend of a friend.
Yeah, so much for diplomacy, huh? You arse-licking bastard! Remember the rule, Jared, for when you play this game. Warriors using two-handed weapons cannot block your heavy attacks. Okay. Let's dodge up here. Because there's an archer that really is asking for a little bit of murder. Okay. That thinned the herd out a bit. Now there's only shield dude. And shield dudes just kind of have to be parried. Or you can hope Axie will actually work on them and let you coup de grace. Yep, there it did. Bam! Yeah, I know what you're talking about now. Yeah, that's... kind of creepy. And now that should make Lambert happy, so... An Andrega warrior, huh? You're level 11. Get out of here. And yes, I swear this is Death March difficulty. Sometimes I have to look. The game gets pretty easy if you are willing to hunt for upgrades and maybe abuse the Quen sign just a little bit. That damn Quen sign is gorgeous. Now that would be a playthrough that would be something to see, a Death March, no Quen playthrough. Why am I running? What's the point of going all the way back? I'll just use the signpost. There we go. Signpost, where are you? There you are. Fantastic. And there are a few things to do on the western half of the island. I think one is a place of power and the other is a guarded treasure. Let me rest till daytime so everyone is outside and awake. Don't you dare rain on me, game. There you are, Timon. Got some bad news for you, buddy. Nah, Geralt actually looks reluctant.
Sadly, Acta's dead. So are your brothers.
What?
What do you mean, how? You said yourself how.
The storm destroyed their boat. Hector was killed. Your brothers felt they'd let you down. Couldn't live with shame. They chose death. Found this letter. Might help you come to terms.
A letter? That's all that's left of them.
Sorry. Didn't find anything else.
You found a key, you liar.
Drink last night, too.
Yep. Geralt, the bearer of bad news.
Last night was...
Now, right. Time to explore a few places to the west, and then I will be good to start writing. Finish this crap up. Get back to the storyline. I can finish this guide off before Deus Ex comes out. Who am I kidding? I'm going to be working on this guide a few more times. See, Jared, you're lucky that you only have Borderlands. I've got Fallout 4 and The Witcher 3 that are both constantly drawing my attention. Cyclops! I could sit here and chop at him for half an hour, but... I'm just going to hit him with Igni a few times and let the fire burn him to death. Oh. Should have realized I was a little too close that time. That's fine. You can hit me once. There you go. Ah, come on, that hit him. Here, have some more fire. High sign intensity. Is there anything you can't do? Of course, you're gonna count me as in combat. Alright, come on, you damn echidna, siren, whatever you are. No, no, no. Oop. You wanted to fight so bad, let's go for it. Yeah, now they're gonna fly around and not get into a battle. Come on. Stupid boat. There you go. You're not gonna get saved by any boat this time. Damn it. There we go. Finally, you're going to dedicate to actually fighting. Instead of just wasting my time. And there's one. Geralt is not gentle with monsters he kills. Let's just put it that way. What an unfortunate spot for you to land. You saw how little damage that did to me, though, Jared. I mean, you can see the little end of my life bar is not quite filled. Sometimes, they will randomly just hit for, like, a quarter of my life bar. That's the kind of, damage variability that sometimes... happens with this game. So And it's not like just there's one strong one or one out of 10 of their attacks are strong. Once in a while, every enemy will just do that much damage. I have not yet figured out why that is the case. Nothing but mutton to eat. Get out of the way. Things are bothering me. Where is this damn place of power? Place of power, where are you? Yep. I should probably follow my own quest marker if I'm ever going to find it, huh? So you're off over there. Okay, so this road should get me there. And I bet these are just a bunch of stupid wolves up here. I have no interest in fighting you. You will kill about 4 million wolves in this game, so... the novelty wears off very, very quickly. If I never have to kill another wolf in The Witcher 3 again, it will be too soon. And hooray! A shrine, a place of power. Yes, thank you, Geralt. You need close enough to drop him? There you are. Yeah, we'll go with this angle here, huh? And another ability point that I'm not going to end up using, because I'm stupidly hoarding them for some reason. Seriously, I should just decide what I want to do with this character and do it, but given how much I'm using signs, I should probably get that passive that boosts your sign intensity for every bit of medium armor you're wearing. That should be all these quests, so I guess now it's time to head back to Novigrad. The supervisor. Alright, I gotta meet Lambert. So I got the Necker card off of Hammond. And I've been buying every card that I've come across at the inn. I've won all the rare cards. Let me see what that little book says. Which CD Projekt generally put into the game sometime after launch, because they realized what a unsatisfying scavenger hunt. Gwent could be. I hope I can get that quest sword on. Well, it doesn't matter. Where is that book? Two in Velen, six in Novigrad. Right, I still didn't do that quest, High Stakes Gwent, but that should only be five cards. Either there are cards I'm not thinking about, or the game is miscounting, because the only cards I should have left, if my memory serves, are the five. I think there's four or five from High Stakes Gwent, and then there's the one card from Lambert, which I'm going to get presently. Oh, Geralt, stop lighting the damn torch. There we go. So, let's go back to Novigrad. And the Oxenfurt Gate sounds close enough to me. One of the things I really dislike about this game, and there aren't too many of them, but, the narration, every time you load, gets really, really, really old. Thank you, sir. You are a scholar and a gentleman. May the gods smile benevolently upon your endeavors. I look forward to the new guide. Well, thanks, buddy. Thanks. A little bit much there, but screw it, I'll take it. So, Jared, do you have Alien Nation? Do you still not have that game? All right, come on. Loading. Oh, man. These new consoles couldn't come fast enough. Even though their CPUs are barely an upgrade, so it's probably not going to help that much. Dude, guard, what are you doing? How's it going up there, buddy? Yes, I'm greatly amused by glitches of this mundane variety in games. That's fantastic. I love it. Oh, screw it. I'll go around this whole block of buildings. Who designed this crappy city with no through alleys? There's the nowhere inn. So let me rest until daytime. I like operating in the day. Makes for better screenshots. Unless it's raining. Which it is not. Fantastic. Hey, Lambert, what's up? Well, then what the hell did we need to do all that for?
Anything on Solis? Well, didn't have you there to stand up for him. All right, let's pay Carradine a visit.
Nope. You're gonna teleport me there. I should have picked the other option, I'm thinking. That way I could play Gwent with Lambert real quick. Oh well.
I think I know how to get in. I've got a plan. If your plan doesn't include dealing with an escort of guardsmen, best revise it. Calm now. Let them start it.
You're expected. Come in.
That's not the, interaction with guards Geralt usually has, unfortunately.
Make yourselves at home.
Yeah, you can tell by the eyes he's a witcher.
He's a witcher.
Yeah.
Very true. Allow me to introduce my wife Leticia and my two little tots. You know who I am, and I've heard of you. You've been asking many questions about me. That always draws my attention. What school do you come out of? That of the camp. So few of us left.
I don't think Lambert likes this guy.
Witchers can't have children.
But they can have wards, or take in a woman along with her children, embrace them as their own.
merchant.
Why ever not? Not one among us doesn't dream of changing our life.
Oh, come on. Some witchers actually like killing monsters.
They say no,
I just haven't met one.
It remains to be seen. My friend needs to talk to you.
Lads, take the children and Letitia and leave us. Our guests wish to speak to you.
I'm all ears. Talk to him, Geralt. If I do, first word he says to me, I'll lose it and throw out a the fucker.
Chill out, Lambie.
Nice place you got.
As it turned out, I have a flair for enterprise. Now I've coin enough to provide my family with the finer things in life.
With some left over for philanthropy.
Miss Marabella's Institute does not scorn small donations. Neither does the city's Widows and Orphans Relief Fund, amongst them.
Your wife know who you were?
We are thoroughly honest with one another. Harbor no secrets. She prays for me each day. You know what? I think it's working.
Fucking hell.
Relax, Lambert.
I confessed all just before we pledged to marry one another. Began a new life that day with a clean slate.
Remember Aiden? The Witcher. Murdered in Elander. Guessing the killers were paid well.
I remember him as I remember all the others, with the deepest regret. Yet Aiden was different in a way. Contrary to rumor, we did not set out to kill him. We were forced to when he attacked us.
The cat school witchers are somewhat prone to be on the assassin side of things. It's surprising how little they go into the Witcher schools in this game. You're fairly acquainted with the School of the Wolf. There's about four of them left. And the other schools they mention, like the School of the Viper, the School of the Cat, the School of the Bear, the School of the Griffin, but you only get casual mentions of those at best, so there's a lot of lore in the Witcher universe that's really just not really touched on. Lots of fodder for sequels and prequels and spin-offs. what do you think? Should I kill him or should I let him go? Former Witcher assassin who's changed his life to become a merchant. I'll kill him.
You know what, Carradine? Your remorse. It's feigned. Completely dishonest. You put on a good show, but I just don't believe you.
Don't even know why we bothered with this chat. We came here to kill you.
Yeah, your ass is grass, buddy.
Your friend. Your vengeance.
You've been waiting a long time for this.
And I don't aim to die.
Yep. You can at least give me time to take out my sword game. Ooh. Right in the face.
Thanks for your help, Geralt.
No problem, buddy.
Want to talk about it?
No.
You're not as cool as Eskel, but you're still one of the crew. So let's talk to him real quick while he's still around, if we can. There we go.
Can we talk?
What about?
You have a card I want, buddy.
Ever play Gwent?
Of course. Even tried to teach Vesemir, but turned out he's just mule-headed. Why do you ask? Up for a quick hand?
Yes, I am. yeah, I hope I get a good hand so that actually comes true. What's he playing? Scoia'tael deck, huh? Nothing villain Tretton Mirth can't fix. Too bad I didn't draw him. Not a single damn spy card in that old deck. You have got to be kidding me. It's kind of a weak hand. I'll see if I can't draw a Scorch out of him. Hopefully it'll at least force him to... Yeah, I figured I would draw a Scorch. That's all you're going to do, huh? Okay. Now, please, could you give me a spy? No, another decoy. This might not go so well. Hey, never dead, Zed. In fact, I'm pretty sure I'm going to lose this game because they gave me such a crappy hand. I'll try to draw him out and waste his time. Might be my only chance. Yeah. Oh, you're gonna spam your medic, huh? Uh-oh. I hear the pitter-pattering of some woman outside. And... No, I'll rest with that. Hopefully... 3-4, I can still out-card him. No, this is actually my second playthrough of the game. This is a fresh playthrough, but I've beaten the game before. Claire is the one who's on her first playthrough. You're out of cards there, so it looks like I'm gonna actually win with this amazingly crappy hand. Thank you, I'll take Triss. Sorry there, Lambert. But when it comes to Witcher and his Gwent, no one gets in the way of it. So, aside from high-stakes Gwent, that should be all the Gwent cards out there. Now, there's some sweet loot I can get in this area now that I couldn't get to earlier because of level. And that's exactly what my guide wants to do next, so... Condyle. Alright, let's go fast travel there. Out of the way, you witch hunters. Is this Tredegar Square? No, this will lead down to Tredegar Square, though. Alright, areas I haven't cleared on this map yet. Now, there aren't that many water events, fortunately, so I don't have to worry about that. Lots of stuff up there. This whole island was high level. Yeah, just a scattered little bit here and there. This hasn't been done because a main quest takes you there, I think. So, I remember there was a powerful hag here. by Condyle, so let's go get rid of her. Yeah, yeah, Ithilien's prophecy. Same thing they've been yabbering about for the past two games now. A seed which will sprout fire and blah, 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 blah. If there's any chance I can hit level 26 while doing some of this stuff, that would be fantastic. It would be very nice to be able to upgrade my gear again. Water hags are necrophages, I think. Man, I really need to get my hands on superior necrophage oil. I'm still stuck with enhanced. There you are. Whoa! Level 28 Grave Hag! What is she doing? Cut it out! Stop digging! Ah, okay. I remember grave hags. Oop. Right. Use your tongue so I can try and parry that. Oh, that was too far away. Ah, Quinn, you're just too powerful. Get out of here. Now, hidden treasure. Means there's probably some body here. No, you're not the... Wait, that can't be the treasure. That's not hidden at all. That's locked. Okay, I gotta find the key. Alright, that explains it a little better, I guess. Looks like there's drowners in the water nearby, so I'm not gonna go there. Something I can loot over there, but what is it? That is literally the first time I've seen those items. Come on, scooch up closer. There you go. Go away, Witcher Sight. I don't need you. There we go. You don't have my key on you, huh? Now, there has to be a corpse around here somewhere with the key on them. Yeah, look at all those drowners over there. Swamp is thick with them. No, that's just a corpse with an apple on it. Stupid tree, get out of the way. What are you? Oh, you're just blood moss. Nope. Oh. No, not long. There's a bush over here. Usually these things aren't that far away, so curious where this is. Mushrooms, more mushrooms.
Tell if you love the gods. Right, me lovers, to work.
So behind a level 28 grave hag are level 7 bandits. Not really great progression there, but certainly one of you doesn't have the key. That would just be silly. Mushrooms, hardened leather. No key here, just a random bandit camp. How the hell were they ever going to get off this peninsula? I don't think they were going to make it past the level 28 grave hag. Okay, it must be closer to the house. Okay, where are you? Oh, duh. How about this obvious body sitting up here? Go away, you stupid glow. I'm trying to get a screenshot. There you are. Key to burn down house. Read the letter, start the quest. Loot the chest, end the quest. Come on, where's my prompt? There you are. Another Haeravon, huh? That was the name of a sword in the first Witcher. Actually a fairly decent sword. If I remember correctly, you could find it in the swamp forest on a corpse, and it was a pretty decent upgrade. I think it was a steel sword. And there were far, far, far fewer swords that you could get in the first game. At least it seems that way to me. As far as, especially as far as silver swords go. Alright, what do I want to clear out next? I think there was... Actually, you know what? I'm already overstepping the bounds of what I'm doing, and I've got to save my beautiful voice for a podcast later, so I will call that a stream. Thank you for everyone who showed up. Should have ended it with Gwent, but whatever. Good enough.